Now, an animal hoarding case out of Monterey. One woman there accused of keeping more than 50 dogs and cats in her home. Several dead animals were reportedly found as well. Well, this afternoon, Isla Jean Qualia made her first court appearance to face charges, felony charges, of animal cruelty. This case is highlighting the prevalence of animal hoarding behavior in society. And Action News reporter Mae Chow has more on that tonight, live from our Salinas newsroom.
Dan, a popular cable show about compulsive hoarders and this recent animal hoarding case out of Monterey have put a spotlight on a mental disorder that psychiatrists say often go unreported, but one that is treatable.
And you received a copy of the complaint?
In court Thursday, 59-year-old Isla Jean Qualia pleaded not guilty to four felony counts of animal cruelty and one misdemeanor charge of failure to care for animals. On April 27th, Monterey police and SPCA humane investigators discovered 22 cats, 24 dogs, and 7 puppies inside Qualia's home, which authorities described as being buried in several feet of garbage, urine, and feces.
For most people, we would say it's absolutely unlivable. The fact that this woman was living in there of her own volition is just a demonstration of how much care she was in need of.
Qualia is not alone. According to the American Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals, this type of hoarding is becoming more and more prevalent. Dr. Jerry Ainsworth is a staff psychiatrist at Community Hospital of the Monterey Peninsula.
I think that this is a much more prevalent problem than people really understand. It's probably a 2 to 4% prevalence in society. And so we're just not really that aware of it because there's so many people out there who never invite other people into their homes, and we don't really know about it until a fire breaks out or smells start coming from a house.
Hoarding is not yet considered an official distinct disorder. Some studies suggest it may be a symptom of obsessive compulsive disorder, but many people who hoard don't have other OCD-related symptoms.
We consider it a disorder when it really starts interfering with people's functioning, such as social functioning. Many of the people who hoard will not allow other people to come into their homes. A lot of times they are unable to maintain even personal relationships.
Dr. Ainsworth goes on to say that animal hoarders fall victim to their own good intentions and end up emotionally overwhelmed, socially isolated, and alienated from family and friends. Dan.
All right. Thank you very much. Appreciate it, May. The judge did grant Qualia supervised release on the condition she live with another adult and not own or care for animals. She signed a release to surrender the 53 dogs and cats to the SPCA. They hope to be placed in foster care.